I formally apologize as President of the United States of America for what we did. I formally apologize.
For the first time, a sitting U.S. president has apologized, as you just saw, for an era of American history that ripped Native American children from their parents and sent them to boarding schools, and often cases they were abused. In recent years, we have talked to those impacted by these schools. Many of them were right here in Minnesota, and today Kent reconnected with one to find out what that apology means to them.
Roughly 50 years after the U.S. put an end to the era of Native American boarding schools, it's still hard to describe.
One of the most horrific chapters in American history. We should be ashamed. A chapter that most Americans don't know about.
My family has two generations of boarding school history that I know of.
Christine Dindisi McCleave spoke to Chris Horapsky for his Care 11 series Lost History, which explored the impact of Native American boarding schools, which began around 1820. By 1879, U.S. Army Captain Richard Henry Pratt established the first federally funded off-reservation Indian school in Pennsylvania, famously saying they must get into the swim of American citizenship, kill the Indian in him, and save the man.
But he also created propaganda. He took before and after photos of these students to prove that his experiment worked and that the Indians could be quote-unquote civilized.
Generations of Native children stolen, taken away to places they didn't know. Children abused, emotionally, physically, and sexually abused. Forced into hard labor. Some put up for adoption without the consent of their birth parents. Some left for dead and unmarked graves.
The president's acknowledgement of those horrors today came after years of work by the National Native American Boarding School Healing Coalition, a group Christine led until 2022.
Yeah, I struggle between, you know, what I'm supposed to say and what I really feel.
Why do you say that?
Well, because today is historic, and while I am grateful to see this progress being made, I'm also realizing just how short it falls from real reparations, from real healing.
And she knows she's not alone. The Healing Coalition surveyed boarding school survivors in 2016.
The thing they wanted the least was an apology, because while it is an acknowledgement, it doesn't change anything. The majority of them said that they wanted a truth commission, trying to find out exactly how many boarding schools existed, how many children went to those schools, and how many children died at those schools.
An investigation led by Interior Secretary Deb Haaland, whose grandparents and mother were among those sent to these schools, did help, but she says it didn't go far enough.
They were only able to investigate the federal government's records. Half of these schools were run by churches of various denominations, and so a truth commission would be able to look into those records as well.
Nearly 1,000 documented Native child deaths, though the real number is likely to be much, much higher.
Bills in both the House and Senate could make that commission a reality, but until it happens, Christine says she can't ignore the politics of an apology in a swing state just before an election.
This apology doesn't change anything for my mother, who was abused as a child, or for my grandfather, who was abused at a Catholic Indian boarding school.
Do you hope that this isn't an election ploy?
I hope that this apology actually helps that bill get passed. Native American people are no stranger to being political pawns. You know what? If this is an election ploy, so be it. I hope something good comes out of it.
During the speech, President Biden did acknowledge that the apology, it comes 50 years too late. But he did not address that legislation you just heard about, which would establish a Truth and Healing Commission. Jana.
Which is that logical next step. And kudos to her for not just saying, oh, here is your day. She wants more.
Yeah, and that was something that was echoed throughout today, even amongst those that were in attendance, saying it's a first step. It's a historic first step, but it is just a first step.